Hey, what's up? In the previous Meta project, I was able to build a Meta accessory that runs on the ESP32 S3 dev kit by directly building the ESP32 example provided by Meta. This allows you to easily control devices in your home from outside by linking with Apple HomeKit. Meta accessories are also available through Siri. It makes sense because it's connected via HomeKit. This means that we can create home IoT very easily by creating the IoT devices we want. For example, this could be controlling the garage door lock, lights, temperature, and humidity in the house. However, it's really difficult for non-developers to build a development environment to configure these IoT devices. In general, an ESP IDF environment is required to create Meta accessories with an ESP32. If you had to start from scratch, it would take a lot of time and effort. Additionally, you may not get the results you want. So, Espressif recognizes this and has launched a web service that allows users to create Meta devices very easily. Using this, you can create a Meta device with just a few clicks. It's really awesome. Let's make it together from now on. This is a service called ESP ZeroCode officially provided by Espressif. This allows you to create Meta devices very easily. That means you don't have to write any code. This is a list of currently supported functions. It seems that all basic functions are provided. The device I will use this time is C3 DevKit M1. This would be great for testing since it has a built-in LED strip. This is a list of C3 threads. I will choose my device. If you have a different device, please select yours. Since I choose the LED strip function, it automatically loads the configuration of the device I selected. If you use a different GPIO, you can modify it here. ESP ZeroCode is actually targeting manufacturers rather than individuals, because they need to make money too. This helps you create actual Meta products. I think startups and small companies can utilize this to create their products more easily. As a hobbyist, I have no plans to sell Meta products, so this is not for me. Just making a testing device is enough. Okay, I think my code is ready. Now let's connect the device and flash it. Because the code is already built, it goes very quickly. If you build it in ESP IDF, you really have to wait a few minutes. Now my CS device is a Meta accessory with the write function. It's very simple. Here you can see a QR code for this device. Through this, device settings are made. I will register the Meta accessory through this on my iPhone. Enabling Meta devices in HomeKit is very easy. As mentioned in the previous video, a hub device such as Apple TV is required. Without this, you will not be able to connect. Also, I can see this message because my device is not an official device. If you don't like this, you need to get a Meta certificate. You can also get a product certificate here. I think it will be of great help when making actual products. All set, now this device is connected to my HomeKit. It works as expected. It makes it very simple for us to create IoT devices that runs on the Meta framework. If you have an ESP32 device, please try it. You will be surprised at how easy it is to make. I'm preparing for my next project using this. I will do my best to share more practical projects. All right, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.